Hello everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer, and welcome back to Monster Hunter World. Now, in the last episode, I honestly don't remember what I did once again. I hate when that happens, I can't remember what I did in the last episode. Oh yeah, I defeated Kushala Deora, that's right. I've changed some of my gear a bit, too, since the last one. I tried out some other weapons, too, such as this. This, I actually enjoy this. I'm gonna go and show this off a little bit here. The reason I changed my gear is because I was fighting Nergigante and I was having a little bit of trouble with it, so went and changed some gear around a little bit and I'm doing good now. Took him out in 18 minutes in the in my own time the last time I tried. And you might see my in-game voice chat thing come up next to my mic or next to my webcam up there. Like up in this area, you'll see a little thing pop up with a speaker symbol. That's because I've got voice chat turned on because I was helping my brother out with some stuff yesterday, so Hopefully that doesn't make any sort of difference in the recording. I don't think it will, but I guess we'll find out. Yeah, with these you've got this thing called demon mode, which it drains your stamina while you do it, but you can do combos like this, which I completely missed with.
Thank you.
are just ridiculously fast. That was quick. And I cut its tail off in the process. I mean, granted, these are higher level dual blades, but still. Might be wondering why I'm doing that. I'm trying to get... There's a rare one that can spawn in here sometimes. I think it was called a Moonlight Flutterfly or something like that. I actually got, like, the rarest endemic life form in the game yesterday. Was it a... something or other crake? And it spawns in here. Oh. I found it here. I'm sure it'll spawn in other locations, but... I'm trying to capture all of the endemic life because you get an achievement for it, I guess. I caught like 3 or 4 new ones yesterday alone. You know what? Since I'm here, I'm gonna check for one that I know is supposed to spawn. Occasionally back in here. Not in here, but back in this part with the lump of meat. I don't know if the lump of meat is here though, but. Oh yeah, it's here. Supposedly one can spawn in here. I saw something moving up there. I thought I did anyways. It's a rare form of the gloom gecko called a moonlight gecko. I swear I read that it could spawn in here by this lump of meat. Saw the net thing turn orange for a second. Shit, I've got my palico with me, so I won't be able to catch that bird. The crake or whatever it was. Because he scares it off. You gotta wear the ghillie mantle and you gotta crawl up or sneak up there, and yeah, it's very difficult to capture it, I guess. And supposedly it is the rarest one, but my first try after learning that it's where it was, my first try I went to the area and there it was, so I guess I was just lucky with that one. Yeah, I used the ghillie mantle because it was recommended to use the ghillie mantle to get close enough to capture it. And it was recommended you leave your palico at camp. I mean, I can look and see if I can spot it, but I know I won't be able to. Nope, it's not here. It's on his back. It's a puffy bird that sits on his back. There's also a rare fish that spawns in here, I believe it was. A petrocanth. It's an ancient fish of some kind. It's either in there or over in this pond here. Doesn't look like there's anything out here. That's odd. Are they just hiding behind rocks or something? There's always like three fish out here. Where are they at? Every time I came in here, there was like three fish out there. But yeah, it doesn't look like the petrocanth is here. Because I saw a picture of it and it doesn't look like those things. It looks different. Yeah, there's a few endemic life forms that I haven't got yet. I'm gonna double check to make sure that gecko isn't over here. And then I'm gonna head back and check one of the other locations maybe. Gecko. Might as well carve a large monster bone off of this thing. Yeah, I'll head back to my room and I can show that bird that I caught. There's actually two different kinds of the crake. There's a downy crake, and then there's the other one. I can't remember what its name was. The downy crake was actually kind of tricky to find as well. And if you notice, I'm not wearing the gala suit anymore just because I was getting tired of that. Yeah, I caught this one, the dapper coral bird, as opposed to the elegant coral bird. It's more of a purple color. Bristly crake. There's the downy crake. I don't even see it. And there's the bristly crake. There's the downy crake. Where's the other one then? Ah, there he is. But yeah, those two are pretty rare, I guess. The bristly crake especially. Then there was the tyrant hopper I've already got. Okay, I don't need to find that one then. I got a giant vigor wasp. The Wiggler Queen. There's a Hercudrome. I found a gold Hercudrome before, but there's the Hercudrome, which I hadn't found yet. There's an auger fly, apparently, which is similar to these omen flies, but it only comes out in the rain, I guess. There's a pilot hare, which I had seen that pink, the pink hare that I had seen before. That's a pilot hare, not a shepherd hare. It's a rare one, and I can't seem to find one now after I've tried. Now that I'm trying to find them, I can't seem to find them. I did the other chef quest that he had given me on my own time to defeat 10 of those Gachalaka things, because that was just irritating more than anything. Let's go and visit the endemic life researcher here, see what she wants me to get for her. Not to mention there's like three of the endemic life things that I still need that I could possibly get here. Four of them on a rainy day. Got enough of that intel I mentioned before. So there's this legendary bird I've been chasing up until recently. Phantom bird. Really? That's the really rare one that I mentioned. The bristly crake. Leave you at home then. There's a moss swine around here somewhere. And the bristly crake seems to spawn on their backs. Doesn't have one on him. I don't even know if I can catch one of those here or not. I don't know the moss swine spawns by heart. Which means this could be tricky. Tempered Peaky Peaky, or Puke Puke if you want to call it by its actual name. I prefer my name. Tempered Anjanath. Ooh. Tempered monsters are even more dangerous or even stronger versions of the even more difficult and dangerous than high rank monsters. trying to remember how to get to. I know there's a moss swine around here somewhere. I know there's a couple of them around somewhere. I just can't remember how to. Can't remember exactly how to get to them. Spot I was thinking of that has one. No, it was somewhere else nearby. Somewhere else, one of these other things that looks similar to this that's got one. Oh no, there's one right there, that's right. You don't have any on you though. Although I'm not wearing the ghillie mantle, there could have been one and it might have got scared away already before I even got there. Because my ghillie mantle isn't ready to use again just yet. There's also another version of those woodland Terex, or whatever it's called. Called a forest Terex, that I can find. I would assume that would be in places like this. Basically the same places as the other ones can spawn, I would think. Now, somewhere through here, I believe there was another moss swine around. Unless I'm confusing this with another location, which is very possible. The one I was thinking of, but it doesn't have a thing on its back either. Yeah, because I was thinking about this place, and that's the one that lives down in here. Yeah, and anywhere those shepherd hare things can spawn, you can find the pilot hare, I guess. Thank you. the bristly crake as the phantom bird. Okay, so yeah, the bristly crake can't even spawn in that place, so I guess I'll have to hope I can get lucky and find one in here again. Not this time. What about that fish? No. Yeah, see, there's fish over there now. Why weren't there any before? Bristly crake can spawn here as well. She's probably talking about the other one, knowing my luck. Yeah, there was supposedly a moonlight gecko right over here, but I never saw one there, so the petrachanth, or the ancient fish, can spawn in here apparently as well. And it's a large fish, so you have to do that little mini game, but it's set in the far left, and the only fish I see in here looks like a platinum fish. Oh, and a bait bug is necessary to capture the ancient thing. You need bait bugs to lure them and capture them. I don't know where the bristly crake would spawn here. I don't remember, were there moss swine around here somewhere? Looks like an Azure Rathalos is over there. Yeah, I've got literally no clue where a Bristly Crake would spawn here. Yeah, that's Azure Rathalos. I know those already. Don't know why it's showing up as a question mark. I literally have no clue where to look for this Bristly Crake here. Yeah, another spot the Moonlight Gecko could spawn was apparently through here in all of these geckos, and that wasn't easy to try to capture all of them to see if it was in there. Oh, what happened there, I wonder? I don't remember if there's moss swine in here anywhere or not. I'm not remembering any, but that doesn't mean there aren't any. Just because I don't remember seeing them doesn't mean they're not here. Because that's the only place I've seen those things before, so that is on the back of a moss swine. So I don't know of anywhere else I could find them. There may be other places you can find them, but that's the only one I know of. Yeah, this is still being set up.
Camp here would make our lives so much easier. Let's finish up so they can get to it.
You know what? I'm gonna go and get the supply I need for that. Well, I'm gonna try to. That thing that we just passed over here, that Dodogama. That's what I need. I need a Dodogama Hide Plus. material from it somewhere, though. There it is. Where'd you go, you chubby lizard? There you are. No. Well, the good news is my damage and my defense have just been increased. This could be useful. So why is it able to stand in the lava without taking damage, but when this thing shot off, it took damage from it? Thank you. fighting Nergigante this last time that I didn't know was a thing. You can climb these crystals. You can literally run up these crystals. Oh, as long as you don't have something that breaks them on you. Didn't know that worked. And you learn something new every day. Off that from splint looked like it could have been. There we go, that's what I needed. Yeah, it's a Rathalos went into my shock trap. Going to the workshop. I don't need to go to the workshop, damn it. At least I remembered that I can do that. quest is better at it, huh? Okay. Do we have a Dodogama tree? Dodogama tree. Blessed. Okay, I figured that's what it would be. Yeah, I don't know why I went there. I need to go down here and talk to these guys so I can get that camp set up.
Considerable accomplishment.
Your weakness is thunder. Okay. I'm gonna guess that since she told me to get that thing out here in the forest, it's the one that can spawn out here in the forest. So let's just go with that logic for now. Until proven wrong, and then I'll have to go and get the other one. Oh, and it's raining. Awesome. Just going to assume it's the one that can spawn out here, and it spawns on the backs of these type of herbivores, so it will be on these things or the other ones that are in the wild spire wastes. Can't think of the name of those ones. Captainoth's over this way, I guess. Sort of this way. I should have just gone this way to begin with. Gave me a dash juice, and then that was it. Shit. If I had gone straight this way, I could have got here before that wore off. That's probably gonna scare the bird away if it's here anyways, so. If the bird had been here, it's gone now. I would assume. Suppose I could go and look for an auger fly since it's raining. Wait, that bird can't spawn on the back of a moss slime, can it? Because technically they are an herbivore. Mushrooms, but that's still a plant, I guess. Technically, sort of, not really. Not really, but close enough. I would assume that the forest Terex can spawn with those ones. I could look it up, but I'd rather not take the time to do that right now. I've got other stuff that I want to do. Alt. The omen flies, of course. It would be nice if it did. But that's probably exactly why it doesn't. Because that would make it too easy. No point in doing that. I swear I keep seeing stuff. I did see something, didn't I? I can't reach you, damn it. Fine, I'll wait for you to come back over here then. Got him in the air. Just swiped him right out of the air. So apparently there's this mod out there for this game that's like a quest editor or something like that it was called. And you can change like the size and color of monsters and stuff, and I saw a video somebody did where they messed with this stuff and it was pretty funny. Huh. had no idea that was a thing. There's a couple of omen flies. That's all they were, was just omen flies, okay.
Oh.
Now those hair things are down in here. I saw something run past under me. I swear I keep seeing stuff. Were just those things. Nope, can't capture them. I had a feeling you couldn't capture those, but I had to try. Couple of those guys out here. How am I ever gonna capture those? They keep flying too high. What the hell? Really, am I too close to it? That was it, huh? I was too close. You know, at first I was thinking it's kind of cruel to just come out and just capture all these things that are just trying to live out here, but then I got to realizing I'm literally out here killing things and taking their parts and making weapons and armor out of it too. So I think capturing these things and letting them live is kind of not too bad of a thing to do. It could be worse. I swear that turned orange for a second when I pulled it out. Really? Really, that's what you're gonna do to me? I'm just wasting all kinds of time here trying to capture all these things, aren't I? Oh. And the thing is, I have a feeling I'm not gonna find the ones that I want. Looks like it's a path. I don't know how I would get to it. Unless it's a path that monsters use to travel through. In which case, I can't use it. I'm going to guess that I'm wasting my time here, and the auger flies would look different from the omen flies. Most likely. That would make sense, they would look different. But considering I can only try to get those things on rainy days, I kind of want to try to get them while I've got the chance. While it's raining, because that doesn't... There's no way to predict when that's going to happen, as far as I know. Is it possible to get up on that part that they walk across up there? I've thought about that multiple times, but I never really tried. Is there a way to get to their path that they use to climb across and stuff? I don't think there is. And even if there was, I don't see why you would need to. No, it doesn't look like there's any way to get up there. Or any reason to, for that matter. I just thought, you know what? I've never really thought about it. Can I get up there? Or I've never really looked into it, I mean. I've thought about it multiple times, but I've never decided to actually look and see if I could. No puffy white bird on any of them. At this point, I think I'm just wasting my time out here. Stuck. I mean, you do get research points for capturing things like this, so... That's cool, I've never seen one of the monsters drinking water before. Or if I have, I don't remember it. That one looks a little different. Maybe not. Did at first, but then when I got closer to it, I realized it didn't look any different. Oh, come on. Why won't this guy just leave me alone? Always weird. Pretty sure that's not supposed to happen. Monsters aren't supposed to be able to get into your camp. Really? I didn't want to jump. Check once more out here for the butterfly thing. something I read said it can spawn rarely in Area 6 near the Pookie Pookie Nest. And that's what this is. This is Area 6, and this is the Pookie Pookie Nest, so... The things I go through to get achievements, like, seriously, there's no need for this, but I want to because there's an achievement for it. Like, you'd have no idea how long I spent trying to do this stuff yesterday on my own time. Just running around capturing things that I spotted. And hoping they were the right ones. Because see, with these butterfly things, it's going to be hard to see without just capturing them if it's the right one or not. I know they've probably got a different color to them that you could notice, but on a day when it's rainy like this, it's harder to see stuff like that, so. My only solution to that problem is just capture as many as I can, and hopefully one of them is the right one. Yeah, okay, I think I'm just gonna go back to... back to base in just a moment here. Is there always three omen flies in here? Got to be kidding me. How did it fly in and land right there? Seriously. Because they fly into wherever they land, don't they? Or wherever they come in at. Don't they fly into the place? So, what I'd like to know is how did it fly in to that log? Or not log, but that little cave thing like that. Okay, I'm gonna head back towards camp. I think it's just a waste of time out here right now. Sucks. I was really hoping, considering there's like four things that I need that I can capture out here, that I would find one of them at least. Nope, none of you are the pink one. No birds on these guys' backs. Okay.
We're on the hunt.
Yeah, so I've been spending a lot of time last night and then in this episode trying to find endemic life forms that I need still, so. Yeah. There's, I believe, three things that I need if I have to capture one of those. One of those white birds. There's three things here that I need still. Well, four, I guess, because I'm sure the... Well, no, there's no rain here today, so the auger fly wouldn't be here. Birds on their backs. Because there's... I've seen the cactuar cutting. Well, I haven't seen it. I saw it moving around and I captured it once. But there's those... There's a blooming version of those that I'm assuming is just a rare version. Like most of these other things are rare versions of the other ones. Took off running, which means that if the birds were there, they're gone now. Apparently, somehow, I was lucky enough to get the... I was lucky enough to get an investigation for that Elder Dragon Kushala Deora. I don't know how, but I got an investigation to go and... find it, I guess. Or hunt it. How am I ever gonna find... There's a normal cactuar there. I was just gonna say, how am I ever gonna find a cactuar cutting again? Because it was so small that I didn't even see it. I just saw something moving. Hey, what are you doing in there? Is that the one? Pilot hair, awesome. He stole their egg. Okay. Okay, where did those Apseros or whatever they're called go? Just that thing. Oh, there's a Rathian here. I guess this wasn't a complete waste. I did get the pilot hair. There you are. No birds on any of you, though. So, apparently, a cactuar actually is one of the most damaging things in the game. I guess the last hit, or one of their... How did the person say it? I think he said the highest damage output, or the highest damage they can hit for, does more than most of the true charged slashes from great swords, which is like the highest damage output in the game in a single attack. They're literally able to kill monsters on their own if you set it up properly. Some monsters they can kill on their own. I mean, obviously it's not going to be able to kill like a Devil Joe or something. I think it was a low rank monsters, but still, that's pretty crazy to think about. You know what? I'm gonna try it out. I wanna show that because it's just insane. It's got to be out in the desert. Do I not have a Kuwayaku one or anything like that? Not. use all of that stuff. Oh yeah, and I remember now. I suppose I could just go on an expedition to do it. We do have a Kuliyakuo there. This will take a bit of setting up because you've got to get the... monster to the cactuar first of all. Then you've got to keep it in place while the cactuar does damage to it. That is provided you can even find a cactuar. The shock trap is to keep them in place once I get the... everything else ready. Ah, there you are. Drawn his attention yet. I need to find a cactuar first. There's not one here, apparently. I believe they could kill a bear off as well, if I remember correctly. I just think the bear-off needed a little more time of holding it in place, which I only have a shock trap, so I wouldn't be able to, like, paralyze it or something to keep it in place longer. Oh, the Diablos. That's not what I want. I think I saw them kill a Diablos with one, but it took two cactuars to do it, which takes a long time because they take a long time to respawn, I guess. I'm not even seeing the cactuar out here. really sucks. I don't know where all those things can spawn, even. I know they can spawn here, I know they can spawn out there. And apparently they can spawn over in this area over here, too. Because we saw one there just a little bit ago. Yeah, I didn't know they could spawn out here. See if I can get an investigation for the Kuluyaku. Because then I'll know that there will be a Kuluyaku there. It's just a matter of finding a captor. So yeah, I'm just gonna throw this on and follow the Kuluyaku a little bit. Get its footprints that it leaves. See if I can get a few investigations for the low rank Kuluyaku. Be a capture one because I'd fail because I'm gonna kill it with the captor. That's so cool. I hadn't seen that before. Now that's twice I saw a monster drinking water. So far. Getting over there quick. Where are you taking that egg? he going with the egg? Must be going back to wherever they nest in this place. Is it going to sleep? Or is it just sitting down and resting? Huh. Cool. Well, I didn't get what I wanted out of that, but that was kind of neat. I got some investigations I can do, though. That'll make it a little easier. Because then we can guarantee there's a Kuluyaku out there. And it's just a matter of doing the rest of it. Because with an expedition, I can't always guarantee there will be a Kuluyaku. Can use paralysis ammo. You can use paralysis ammo too. So can you. I'm gonna go with that one then. Let's go and try this then. Or 15 minutes, really? don't give me much time on either of these to go and do what I want to do. I mean, if things work out right, then I don't need that much time, but still. I didn't take the paralysis ammo too with me. I shouldn't need that for paralyzing a low rank Kuluyaku though. If I need to paralyze it at all. My target, but let's try to find us a captor first. Because depending on where the captor is, I might have to just wait for the Kuluyaku to make its rounds to that position. That's why I said they're not giving me much time with 15 or 30 minutes, because it could take a lot of time just waiting for it to get there. Like it's not happening this time. Sucks. Thank you. So this light bow gun that I've got right now seems like it's more meant for status and stuff, like status effects and things like that, as opposed to actually dealing damage. Seriously getting my ass kicked by a bull ring from Yahoo. It's just, I'm getting my ass kicked by this thing. stunning me for one. I mean, the bow gun's just slow. And he's not even ready to capture. There he is. Weird. I'm just gonna kill it though. That was way more difficult than it should have been. That's just sad. Should not have been that difficult for me. Oh boy. Now I'll return to HQ. The Argosy is in port. Let's go and collect what he got. Safari's been back for a little bit. I'll go and get that too.
A considerable accomplishment. Huh?
Vestoid parts, mushrooms, bones, oh, dragon bone relic even, wing drake hide plus, wait, what? They took out a pink raffian. Okay. I think I'm going to end this one here, and I'll get more investigations and stuff done in my own time again. But that's it for this episode. Sorry about that. That's it for this episode. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.